Good morning from Islamabad in Pakistan, and today we're taking a little bit of a road trip across Pakistan, so come with me, let's go on an adventure. I'm taking a ride today then on what I'm told is the best bus service in the whole of Pakistan. It's called the Q Connect, and it's going to take me from here all the way to a place called Lahore. So I'm looking forward to it. It's a long old journey, so it should be a good day out.
My first stop today was to Islamabad bus station, which on the face of it didn't exactly scream first class luxury.
Alright then, this is the bus station in Islamabad. It's about 20 minutes away from downtown on the way out to the airport, and this is the bus, or one of them I think, that I'm going to be taking today. It's called a Q Connect. Apparently it's really nice inside. I don't know, we'll find out when we get on board. I'm reserving judgment at this moment in time, I think.
I headed inside to check in for my ride on the bus.
Hi, good morning.
In your luggage, it's your receiving tags.
Perfect, thank you. Mm-hmm. All right then, so all checked in, got my ticket. It's gonna take me on the bus down to Lahore. There's a little sort of lounge area here that they call it. It's more like a waiting area really, but it's not too bad. It's quite comfortable, comfy sofas and stuff. There's like drinks and things over there, tea, coffee, soda and stuff like that. And there's breakfast as well, but I'm not having breakfast today because it's a bit early yet and I'm not ready for it. But I think we'll be stopping a couple of times for food on the way as well.
My only other experience taking a long distance bus in Asia was when I took a 2-day sleeper bus across India, which really didn't end too well.
This is not a good experience.
I just hoped that this one would be a little bit nicer. I didn't have too long to wait to find out though, as it was soon time to head outside and get on board my bus across Pakistan. I climbed on board, eager to see what the Q Connect would have in store for me on today's ride across the country.
Hello. Number 3A.
Seat number 3A, third row, right side, single
Perfect.
Seat, okay?
Thank you.
Welcome. Well, this didn't seem too bad at all. The seats are in this 1-2 configuration and they looked and felt more like something you'd find on a private jet than on a bus. There were personal TVs and storage above the seats and quite a lot of legroom too.
Right then, welcome on board the Q Connect bus. This is a bit better than Greyhound, isn't it? Look at this. It's like a first class seat. We've got TV screaming at all the seat controls. I'll go through all that in a little while. Very, very smart. Wow. And a proper reclining seat and everything as well. Just like amazing.
Pretty soon everybody was on board and we started our drive out of the bus station towards the motorway heading down to Lahore.
Alright then, we are on the road out of Islamabad on the Q Connect bus. How cool is this? So beautiful, look at this. It's in a sort of 1-2 seat configuration. So you've got single seats down the left side, double seats on the other side. They've got electric recline and everything. Look at this. So the seat controls are all down there. It's pretty cool. We've got all this. It's like Emirates first class. Look at this. Retractable blindy things. Then we've got more controls here. These are the lighting controls, so we can do the put the lights on, reading lamps, stuff like that. In-flight entertainment, on-bus entertainment. We'll go through that in a little bit. And then we've got just here. There's like a tray thing that pops out. And then we've got a bottle of water down here. There is a plug down there, a plug socket as well, 3-pin plug, and a international one as well. Get that back down. Just unbelievable. And we've got a overhead locker as well just above us, so there's a single one on this side. And if you look at the other side, they've got sort of overhead lockers at the seat, which is pretty nice. And there is a I would say a flight attendant as well, but it's not a flight attendant, it's a bus attendant or cabin crew or whatever the right term is, who's been coming around offering drinks and things. Got us on the Wi-Fi. There's Wi-Fi on the bus as well. This thing's just amazing. And like the price that you pay for this is just absolutely insane.
We rolled out of Islamabad, but it wasn't too long before we got stopped at our first checkpoint.
So we've hit an inspection point just outside the bus. So they're just sort of going around checking it all over, I think, and then we'll be getting on his way. So while we're waiting, they come round with some juice. Nice.
Inspection over, and we were soon back on the road heading south.
Right then, let's have a little look around the in-flight entertainment, or should I say the onboard entertainment, the OBE, as I'm going to call it, on the Vistara, no, sorry, the Q-Connect bus down to Lahore. Let's have a look. So it looks like it's an Android tablet, really. It's got all the sort of menu and everything set up on here. You've got access to the internet and stuff on here. You've got YouTube.
Yeah.
But hey, let's see if we can find our favourite influencer on here. Oh. I recognise that guy. Notifications. Make sure you ding that bell. There we go. And you subscribe as well, by the way. That's the little segue link there. Anyway, now what else we got here? We've got some few games that they've put on it and stuff. Not much really. You can install your own stuff. There's like an app store. I think I've not used Android in a very long time. So I think on Play Store, that's what it's called. Play Store. You can install your own games and stuff on it. Don't know whether it works or not, but yeah, it's basically an Android tablet with a few games and stuff on it, and YouTube.
Here's a quick reminder to follow me on Instagram, where I live vlog all of my trips in real time through Instagram stories. You can follow me at noelphillips.official on Instagram. We continued on across Pakistan, and it wasn't too long before we were pulling off the road once again.
Alright, so we stopped again. Not sure if it's another checkpoint or not. We're somewhere on the road down to Lahore. We've been going for about an hour now. So not sure. Driver's got off. I'm guessing hopefully he'll get back on in a minute and we can get on his way.
We weren't stopped for too long though, and pretty soon we were back on the road again. As we continued south, the scenery only got more and more impressive as we began to cross the Salt Range in the north of Punjab.
So the road's getting proper windy now. Beautiful part of the world. Look at this, sort of crossing the mountains. About 2 hours now south of Islamabad, but wow, look at that view. Incredible.
After we crossed the Salt Range, we crossed over the Jhelum River, and not long after that we pulled off the road for a bit of a break, where I saw this rather interestingly named bus.
Alright then, first stop at the side of the road, there's the bus. And we stopped to get some food and drink and stuff, so let's go and see what there is to do here at this little service station. This is quite nice, little service station at the side of the road. They've got a McDonald's and everything here, and some little shops with like snacks and stuff like that. I don't want McDonald's. I've not come all the way to Pakistan to eat McDonald's. I know. Who am I? What have I done with Noel, right? We can't have McDonald's in Pakistan. Let's find something else to eat.
The trouble is, with these rest stops, you never know just how long you've got to eat before getting back on the bus. I didn't want to risk going into a restaurant and missing my bus, ending up stranded at the side of the motorway in rural Punjab. For this reason, I popped to the snack shop and picked up some crisps.
Hey, can I get some potato chips, please?
Curly's?
Curly's? And some water, please. Two water, please.
Water?
Yeah, two, please. Thank you. Thank you. Have a good day. All right, back on board. Just got myself a bag of crisps and some bottles of water. Should do me through. We've only got another... Well, we're sort of 2.5 hours into the journey. I think we're about a third of the way through, I don't know. So if we stop again in a bit, I'll get something else. If we don't, then I'll have something when we get in. No biggie, really. Yeah, let's get back on the road. on the road and they just come round giving out drinks. I've just got a Coke on the bus. And we're back on route, heading down to Lahore. And then we are now about 45 minutes from Lahore. Still on the motorway, still heading south. One thing I do have to say actually, the roads here in Pakistan are just so smooth compared to other places that I've travelled on buses around the world. The motorway is just really smooth, it's in proper decent condition, and it's been a really comfortable ride actually. The bus is a little bit sort of on the rattly side, it's a suspension really on the bus, but I mean you can't beat this comfort really. And if I tell you how much this bus has cost as well, $19 for a trip from Islamabad to Lahore in this level of comfort. $19. Absolutely insane. Just really, really excellent value for money, really. And this is one of the more expensive buses here in Pakistan. You can travel cheaper and end up on a kind of more packed, more busy bus or something with less comfortable seats, I guess. But I mean, this, for $20, man, you can't complain about this. It's just amazing.
Not long after this, things started to get a little bit more built up outside as we started skirting around the outskirts of Lahore. After a journey time of about 5.5 hours, we pulled up in a supermarket car park on the outskirts of Lahore.
Right then, welcome to Lahore, the second biggest city in Pakistan. I'd have quite enjoyed that ride on the bus, actually, on the Q Connect bus. I've got to try and get to a hotel now. We've sort of been dropped off here in the car park of a supermarket, so I'm going to try and get an Uber or something across to my hotel. Let's go.
I booked myself an Uber and pretty soon it turned up at the back of the bus.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
We started on our way to the hotel, but pretty soon it became clear that all was not as it seemed when the driver told me that I'd have to pay cash for my Uber.
So I'm in the Uber headed to my hotel, but I'm a bit concerned what's going on because he's saying that the amount that Uber charging isn't enough and he wants extra. He's not getting extra. Oh, and my Uber ride has just been cancelled in the app apparently. So, this is going to be interesting, isn't it?
We got to the hotel where the fun and games were about to begin. I was told that I needed to pay cash, and what's more, surge pricing had now conveniently kicked in, and the price was now more than double the original rate.
Pay cash. Thank you.
$23.40.
No. 1,000. I saw what you did. You put no. There was no peak. It was 101.6. Surge pricing. You added that on, right? No. 1,000. I'll just pay through the app then. Give me that back. I'll pay through the app. Thank you. I'll do it through Uber. Thank you. Sorry? You don't speak English now?
No.
Ah, okay.
That's funny, isn't it?
Okay. Can I get my bag then? Thank you.
Pay.
Pay through Uber.
No.
That's not what mine says. Thank you. So your Uber app says it's 2,000 rupees, my Uber app says 1,000 rupees.
You mail Uber.
Okay.
We'll pay, you mail Uber, refund Uber cash. You will pay $23.40. And you mail.
Yep, through here, yeah.
You're stuck, app stuck.
Oh, the app stuck, did it? That's convenient, okay.
You mail the Uber.
Let me call Uber. I'll call them.
Somebody
near. Yes, fine, I can call Uber now. My driver is...
I started a conversation with Uber support, which seemed to have the miraculous effect of ending the surge pricing, and the driver was now able to accept the original rate, but in cash only.
How much in app?
1,000.
Back?
Yeah, it's fine. I've asked Uber for help. And Uber support, yeah?
Back. App back.
1,000.
Yeah, you check it.
Yeah, 1,000.
1,000?
Rupees? Yes.
Really?
Is it 1,000?
Okay.
All right, thank you. Good evening, how are you? Okay. He was trying to scam me, so... Thank you.
Now it's worth mentioning that although starting a support chat with Uber was enough to make the driver accept the original rate, albeit in cash, Uber support really were not helpful at all in this instance. They said that because the ride was cancelled by the driver, it wasn't technically an Uber ride, and as a result they couldn't do anything with this drive. So be aware of this scam if you're getting an Uber in a foreign country, it's possible the same thing could happen to you. Uber, you really need to sort out this loophole though, because people book Ubers for the safety and security aspect and they could easily get scammed with no comeback or support through Uber at all.
Alright then, welcome to Lahore, the second biggest city in Pakistan. What view have we got out of my room? Let's have a little look what we've got out here. Oh, you can't quite see it. Oh, there you go. Just a view over a street there. It's not too bad. A great trip down to Lahore from Islamabad on the Quickenet. That was nice. The first impression of Lahore with the Uber driver trying to scam me, though, that wasn't quite as nice. But never mind. These things happen. It's not the end of the world. I ended up only paying what the rate was in Uber anyway. Never mind. So anyway, here in Lahore, here's my room for the night. I've got one night here in Lahore and then tomorrow continuing on the next part of my Pakistan adventure. And I can't wait to share it with you. So hit that subscribe button so you don't miss it. In the meantime, thanks for watching. Take care. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.